What is going on YouTube? This is Captain Corbium here with a controversial video. Now, I'm sure the video title will say something like, Nike is not free to play friendly. And you're going to be like, what? And you're getting ready with the hate comments already, I can tell. But just hold up. There's a reason for my controversial clickbaity title, and it's not clickbait. I have a lot of things to say about this. Okay, so I'm having fun in Nike, absolutely loving the game. The problem isn't crystals, okay? Crystals and pulls, yeah, we have been getting tons of these, right? I've been playing two accounts side by side. So this is my Dolphin account. If we look at this one, I've actually only managed to get 31 Nikes, and I've spent, reasonable amount. I'd say about £40 at this point. And I've only managed to obtain 31 Nikes, but two of those are Pilgrims. And if we look at my free-to-play account, so that's not a good example of, like, you know, pulls and things like that. If you look at my free-to-play account, this one's nuts, right? 34 Nikes, and I've got one Pilgrim, and I haven't spent a single penny on this account. So you might be thinking, well, whoa, man, it's the first week of the game, you've got 34 Nikes, you haven't spent a penny, how is it not free-to-play friendly? Again, the issue isn't the crystals or the pulls. The issue is the daily energy in the game, because if we go over to this account here, okay, these Nikes, this is my main account that I play, I'm now up to level 91, okay, and the main way you're going to build up your power, so if you look at your squad, anyone who plays already knows all this, but yeah, obviously you have, like, I'm at 21,000 right now power, squad power, and the main way to bring that up is through battle chips, right? It's going to be by leveling your characters up. But at level 90 and level 91, it is getting so difficult to get the battle chips to level up one character that there really isn't a good way of gaining extra power, especially for free to play. Because I'm desperate to make some progress on this account, right? So obviously you've got to wait a whole minute for one of these. You can do wipeouts. I'm normally doing one wipeout. I haven't today. But I can show you how little it is. We can do this now, actually. So if I do a wipeout for 50 crystals. Okay, we got 162,000. Now remember, we needed 300,000, right? So I just spent 50 crystals for a wipeout. And I still don't have enough to level up. No. And that gives you 2 hours. Yeah, 120 minutes. That was 2 hours of resources. 50 crystals. So you can see now where the problem lies, right? In 2 hours of charging up, I was able to get it from 30,000 to 200,000. And I need 357,000. So I would probably need to do two more wipeouts. So I would need 3 hours. So that's 6 hours. So we're probably looking at like 5 or 6 hours. And this is at level 91. 5 or 6 hours to level one character up at one level. What I've also been doing is I've been using my event chips, which we've been getting extra ones in the mail. I haven't done it yet today, but I've been going in here and I'm getting extra chips that way. I'm also going to the shop and I'm getting all the chips I can get in here as well. You know what? Let's just get this. Just especially for the video purposes, demonstration. All right, let's get some credit so that I can definitely buy this and it's not a problem. Yeah, so we're about to do another one. So I got that one from the shop. So this is basically the same as getting another wipeout, right? So that's going to be 2 hours of charging up, waiting for the outpost to charge up naturally. Go back to my Nike and, oh, what do you know? I bet it's still not enough. No, it's 288,000. So you can see how it's taking hours and hours and hours and hours to get the resource just to level up one character. The reason the problem's 10 times worse is because unless you've managed to get an extra copy of a character, I went, you can't see because of my camera. I managed to get an extra copy of Noah's body, okay? Because I bought it with my duplicate currency in the body shop. So I've actually managed to be able to get her past level 80. That's the only reason she's not in the chamber. Everybody else obviously has to be in the synchronization chamber, which is why their colors are orange. So the reason this is so much worse is I don't just have to level up one character. When I want the rest of my team to come up, I need to do Rappy, I need to do Ballada, I need to do Neon, and I need to do Anis. Now you saw how many hours it takes just to do one of those characters. So you're literally looking at a day, maybe even longer. A day just to bring my characters up at level 91 to the next power level, to the next level. just to bring my team up one level. And this is just dreadful. Like, this is just not a good energy system. Now, in most games, right? Let me just get my camera back. So in most games like Genshin Impact, Tower of Fantasy, Honkai Impact, you have an energy system. So it's almost like they're using this as an energy system, right? But in most of those games, you have an energy system that has a stable charge rate, okay? It has a linear charge rate. So what that means is, you know, you'll earn so much resin every, whatever it is, 5 minutes. You know, you get a full day's worth of resin, which is 160. You know that each domain costs 20 resin. So you know that every day, if you let your resin charge up, you can do 6 domains, right? And then they also let you do condensed resin, and then they let you do primo gem resin refreshes, and you can get extra resin from the teapot. Genshin is free to play friendly because you can manage your energy levels, right? So if you know you've got a quiet day to day and you just want to do something else, you just want to explore and pick, I don't know, onions and carrots in Monster, and you don't want to do any bosses, then you can just condense your resin and then do extra bosses the next day. So you can see how this game suffers because it doesn't offer any free-to-play friendly ways of doing things. The only other way to solve this problem, by the way, which I find interesting, is if you go into the cash shop every single day under daily, they will sell you... Oh, look at that. Isn't that convenient? For £4.49, they will sell you 30 wipeouts. Now, again, right? We just figured out it takes at least 3 wipeouts to do one character. So, okay, maybe we could do... Maybe that would do 10 levels. So our team might level up 2 levels at this point, right, each. So that would get you 2 levels for £4.49 on each character immediately, which is why I say this isn't free to play friendly. Because if you're happy to give them like nearly a fiver every single day, then yeah, I guess the problem becomes a lot less of a problem, which I find incredibly interesting. So this is why I think it's kind of nefarious what they're doing here, to be honest. I mean, it's one thing to try and monetize people's sort of, you know, anxiety and impatience, if you want to call it that. You know, you want to make progress, you don't want to wait, you want it now, blah blah blah, which is how a lot of these games do make their money. But if you're not offering people a viable way to make meaningful progress on a day-to-day basis without spending money, then you don't have a free, you can't say that it's a free-to-play friendly game. You just can't. I don't care what you say. The only other thing you can do is you can go in here every day. Yeah, you can farm. And I've been doing this, obviously, right? You can go and get your skill chips. You can go and get, you know, see if you can do any more tribe towers. But if you look at how slow this progress is, absolute, like, by squeezing every last battle data that I can, and this includes event, this includes shop, this includes wipeouts, this includes waiting for the charges, in every single way that I know to get these, I'm lucky if I manage to bring my team up by one level a day. And normally that's not enough to meet the next power level requirements. So progress is stagnant right now, and it's only going to get worse if it's like this at level 91. What's it going to be like at 120, for example? It's only going to get worse. So my biggest criticism of this game would be that it just is not free-to-play friendly. Because there's not much point in having a great team of amazing units if you can't do anything with them. If all you can do is sit there and wait for this thing to charge up because you don't meet the current power level requirements, you know, well, that's not really gameplay, is it? But it's interesting how they let you bypass this resource getting bullshit by, you know, opening up your bank account to them. So yeah, it's incredibly disappointing. I really hope they do something to allow free-to-play players and low spenders like me, someone who doesn't want to give them £5 a day. I mean, that's insane, £5 a day. What do they actually, is that what they're expecting then? Is that what they're hoping for? It seems like they are. It seems like they're hoping that people are just going to get impatient and give them £5 a day. What is that? That's 150 quid a month to play a freaking mobile game. Are you insane? That's what you're expecting people to spend, £150 a month just to make progress in the game. So, you know, if you want to disagree, that's up to you. But, you know, if you're going to leave a comment disagreeing, at least explain why you think, no, you're wrong. There's actually, you know, I'm not as bad as you think. And here's why, you know, give me a reason why you think I'm wrong on this. But Yeah, as far as I can see, I cannot see a viable way to make steady progress at this level now without emptying your bank account into the game, which I refuse to do.